Good evening, TheoTrade. This is Corey Rosenblum, and you're watching the Theo Nightly video for November 8th, 2018. We've come a long way this week, thinking about the election and today's Fed day, but also Friday's Apple earnings report and jobs report. We also had Amazon, Netflix, and other big names like Facebook report their earnings. So we're on the other side of all these main news and economic and even earnings events. Where do we go from here? That's the focus of tonight's video. We'll monitor this throughout Friday, the weekend, and plan for the week ahead. We'll start now with a quick overview. Last Friday's Apple earnings report sent shares tumbling, but this week saw them bounce back. The jobs report saw unemployment rate down to new lows, but also jobs that are increasing. So we have good economic data, good economic information, high consumer confidence, and things from the economic sector. This week, we also had the election. Republicans held the Senate, Democrats took the House. That's what was expected, and when there was certainty and not recounts all throughout Wednesday, we had our expected bullish bounce. Also, the Fed did not raise interest rates today in their Fed policy statement, probably will do so in December, and we're on even course and even kilter for additional bullish action and economic expansion. All these things are behind us. Where are we? Into a critical inflection point. This couldn't be more important as a level. For clarity, it's about 2800 in the S&P futures, or to be really precise, it's 2811. And that's one of Don Kaufman's gravity spots, gravity levels, and it's going to be our key inflection point for tomorrow and into the week ahead. If I could oversimplify the plan for you, it would be trade the departure from 2811. That's going to be bullish above, bearish beneath. We'll go into that in more detail, so we're not just playing a random guessing game. We do have a bias, a thought process, and a specific dominant and alternate thesis. Just naming a little bit of things that have happened so far. We had our big rally into January, which gave us the big sell-off into February. Multiple chop, back and forth action, range contraction, another stellar rally up toward our September high, 2950, and our, I'd say, expected September into October volatile decline. And now we're seeing bounce back from that. Notice where the 2018 earlier spot in March, well, that's 2811. Where are we now? 2811. What about September, early October? 2811. So we're here. Will this be the time that we break above it? Well, that's what we're going to plan, assess, put our positions on, and base our swing, intraday, and any option premium sells or purchases from that. The key levels on the other indices, not quite as clear to me at least, in terms of gravity or spot markers. Roughly 26,200 is going to be the spot for the Dow Mini Futures. That's going to be roughly the August high, just shy of the earlier January high. So in that, we take a look at the Nasdaq. It is a little bit clearer for our Nasdaq futures, which is zoom for the majority of 2018. And we see 72.25. That's a couple of spots. That is the March reaction high, well, roughly where we are now. A little support pivot in June into July, 27.25. And where we are at the moment, which is the underside of the falling 50-day exponential moving average. Russell, not giving us too much in terms of price levels, but it's just beneath 1600, roughly 1585. Let's frame out the dominant thesis and the alternate thesis, and we'll take a look at some individual stocks, especially in the tech sector. Given where we are, given the resistance, and given the volume divergences, it's probably more logical to assume that the next move in the market will be down away from 2811, pushing toward 2765, maybe even 2731 once again. That's going to fill out some more of this trading range. And if on a worst case scenario, or best case if you're bearish, beneath 2700. Let's not get too far in the future just yet. Just talking about the immediate swing. And that's going to be the alternate thesis, which is something that the majority of market participants and traders don't think will happen. And if it does, it will trigger movement because it will trigger stop losses and rapid buys to readjust, reallocate, and reposition. That also, again, is 28.11, 28.15, 28.20. So just by definition, the alternate thesis says if something should happen but doesn't, it often leads to a larger than expected move in the opposite direction. That is exactly what we talked about on Tuesday night's video, and the wink wink alternate thesis took us toward our target, which is about 28.11. And that again was the same logic we're going to apply tonight, Thursday. That if the market fails to push lower, as might be expected and as would be expected, we would prepare ourselves to trade defensively or bullishly or protect our accounts on any further upside break. And that upside break could be rapid, and it could result in rapid price action up at least toward 28.50, maybe even 28.75, could be as high, not in one session, but beyond the next week, to 2900. That's the S&P futures and the thought process there. So we will look for any type of bearish swing to trade on a short-term or intraday basis down away from 28.11 toward 27.65, 27.31, or on a really deep pullback, deeper than that, 2700. Alternate thesis, bullish breakout. Let's update our levels, spots on key technology names. We'll start with Microsoft. Now, think of these in terms of the most recent September to October pullback and the most recent into November bounce. We'll categorize all of our plays and opportunities both with the concept of we're expecting a sell swing to come, but if that sell swing doesn't happen, it could lead to a retest of some of these highs, Microsoft included. Its key spot for intraday and short-term traders is going to be the prior high at about 113 per share. Once again, volume divergence, resistance could lead to a sell swing. That's the dominant thesis. That's what we expect. We can't be remiss, and we must prepare to either protect ourselves or trade into an unexpected alternate thesis upside break above 112.50, maybe 113, and that could take us upwards to 116. On Amazon, these are not Fibonacci levels, they're just price numbers and other things that go back to earlier points in 2018. The key one is going to be 1500, and where we see now, which is roughly the intraday high, just a little bit shy of it, and the prior pivot at 1800 per share. In keeping with our thought process, if Amazon falters and fails and trades down away from resistance, it does lead to a sell swing yet to come. But in the future, if we do see that bullish breakout, that puts a upside path toward 1900 or even above that. Note the volume divergence, and that again plays into our dominant thesis that calls for a pullback, but the equal alternate thesis that could lead to a sudden and rapid bullish outcome. That again would trigger stop losses and rapid redeployment of capital back into Amazon. Apple, its earnings were Friday. It's also into a key spot, but a little bit beneath its moving averages and beneath where the expected move was. That was about 210 per share. We're back into 210 per share after a little sell swing post earnings. The earnings took us lower beneath the expected move, but this week has taken us right back into it. So Apple is a neutral play with a downside maybe bias beneath 210. But if this starts to push higher, we do have upwards plays toward 216, 270, or maybe even 222. Netflix also had earnings a little bit ago, but it has, again, hit the expected move, failed all the way down, and this week is pushing back inside. It looks like a bear flag. Volume confirms that it's a bear flag. We don't just want to assume that because odds favor a pullback, and they do, the alternate thesis is going to trigger if we get the breakout. So prepare for any type of bearish action away from resistance, but get ready for any type of bullish plays above, in this case, 338, and make it simple, 340 per share. We'll end with Google, which has a similar pattern, and it's in a bear flag bounce up toward 1100, actually just above 1100, with a potential sell swing back to 1000. If that doesn't happen, the bullish play will trigger in Google, that can break it upwards to 1138, 1150, or maybe even all the way in the future to 1200. So we do these plans not because we're predicting the future, but because we're planning out scenarios, planning out what should happen based on volume and price and moving averages and levels, and therefore we create our trades. But it's also preparing for worst case or best case, if you're bullish and expecting a big bullish surge, that alternate thesis will be your friend if we do see prices break through daily resistance, and that probably comes in multiple stocks, these included. And we'll position accordingly with puts calls or individual contracts. But either way, frame and manage your trades in terms of the immediate departure from current levels in the indices and, of course, in these and other stock opportunities. Take care as always. Be safe. This is Corey Rosenblum with tonight's Theo Nightly video for November 8th, 2018.